So now let me ask you Muslims a question. Oh, I will, I will. I'll let you. The Quran, this book, calls Jesus the Messiah 11 times. But it never explains why. Not once. Why does the Quran call Jesus the Messiah? Are you a Muslim?
I'm Muslim.
Brilliant, let's debate this guy. Stop being rude. Stop being rude. I want to talk to you. Mr. Brown, you've been rude. I want to talk to him. He wants to talk. Do you want to talk to me? Do you want to talk to me? He wants to talk to me. I want to talk to him. Stop being rude. You're being rude. You're being rude. Right.
Jesus is Messiah.
Why is Jesus the Messiah?
Messiah means touch. It's an Arabic word.
What does he mean?
Touch. Touch.
So apparently, Messiah is an Arabic word. It's not a Hebrew word. For 3 weeks, I've asked Muslims this question and they haven't been able to get an answer. Why does the Quran call Jesus the Messiah? Why?
He knows.
Oh, he's not going to answer. It's called running away. Let's listen to the answer.
Messiah, it has two meanings. One is the one who has a power of healing. And Jesus was given a power of healing. Whoever he touched, he healed. Another meaning in Arabic, Messiah means the cleansed one. The one who's cleansed. He was cleansed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he was without sin. Quran says he was without sin. So that's why he called Messiah, because he was the cleansed one. Allah cleansed him from all sins, and as mentioned in the Quran, he's in the Quran.
Please note the Islamic shuffle. He's used the Arabic word Massa, and then Muslims falsely translate this as Messiah. That is not the same word. Do you know, ladies and gentlemen, what the English word is for cleansed? It's cleansed. Do you know what the English word is for healer? It's healer. It's not Messiah.
You ask you for something, like if I ask you, where does it say in the Bible that Jesus says, I am God? You will never be able to show me that he says, I am God. You will bring me
to the topic.
The Messiah. What is a Messiah? The anointed one.
Because kings were anointed with oil.
And you're waiting for a holy king.
When the Redeemer comes, he will eventually become the king.
If Jesus is God, how can he be anointed? It's a great question. The Messiah figure that is prophesied in the Old Testament that the Jews are waiting for is a cosmological figure. Because of his human nature, he is anointed. Because his human nature is anointed, he's anointed due to that fact. So his human nature is anointed because he has to fulfill the law of the prophets so that a faithful Israel can meet a holy God. And to him was given dominion, glory, and a kingdom that all the peoples, nations, and men of every language might serve him. The Son of Man is a figure whose kingdom will be forever. The Son of Man is someone who rules as God on earth.
The writing to talk about Jesus. You were not reading our writing in that
time. Amen.
Perfect.
Amen. The Jesus that the Muslims believe in is not the same Jesus that we Christians believe in. All of you Abrahamic faith people who think we all worship the same God, have the same religion. It's not true. Even the Muslims say it. If he did understand what Messiah meant, he would never have called Jesus the Messiah. Because by calling Jesus the Messiah, you're admitting that Muhammad can't be the last prophet. By calling Jesus the Messiah, you're admitting that Jesus is divine. The Messiah is divine, and that is why the Quran should never have called Jesus Messiah, because Muhammad didn't know or understand the term he was using.